chillin' with Charlie. We chill with Charlie. We're chillin' with Charlie. Chill with Charlie.
Can't believe it. We've got Ragnarok on our side. Sorter's plan just worked. I mean, the Valkyries were a small setback, but I bet we've got Odin worried now. He knows we're coming for him. Think about it. We're gonna show up to Asgard, and Ragnarok's gonna come in and wreck everything. Odin won't stand a chance. We're gonna win. Groa's right.
Groa failed to predict what we would sacrifice in return.
Maybe she could only see the big stuff. This is gonna work, right?
It must. Strength grows.
Hey, check out that cliff. Earthquake must have shook this place up enough to make a ledge.
More of Odin's forces!
Trying to finish the job without restarting! I've got Bifrost on you! Be careful!
So, you've fought in a lot of wars, right? You've never had anything like Ragnarok on your side?
I have. And the creature does not guarantee our victory.
Right. This whole place is gonna fall apart if those keep happening.
Oh!
The Einherjar aren't gonna stop attacking anytime soon. We need to get back. Quiet. I mean, you're always quiet, but this feels different.
I had hoped my days of ceaseless battles were over. I had hoped to never see my son go to war.
We have to destroy his shield!
Ragnarok is here. They know what that means for Asgard.
Behind you! Watch out! That is Hosker!
Do I look like your nurse?
Through this crack in the rocks when you're ready. Father, I know we're doing the right thing. Ragnarok has to happen.
The price we and others paid for this war is high. It will only get higher.
It'll be worth it.
And yes, my usefulness to a certain Vanir Numpty did run out.
Ragnarok awaits our call.
As do the armies of Hell. Thanks mostly to me. It seems war is upon us at last. Where to now, brother? We've some time before we're expected at the temple.
This could be our last chance, Father. Is there anything you want to finish up?
This is it, then. The beginning of the end.
The end for Odin. And after that, a new beginning for the rest of us.
Atreus.
I know. I'm just looking forward to seeing all the realms finally standing up to him. Elves and dwarves and Hell itself.
You are so certain they will unite.
They have to. After everything they've been through. They have to. Don't they? Anything in Midgard you want to do? You know, while we still can?
Freya and the others are still making preparations for the attack, so there's time. So, sounds like things went well enough in Muspelheim.
I mean, probably. Surtur didn't want Samar involved. So instead of them combining to form the Ragnarok Beast, we did a workaround that left her out of it.
Well, hopefully he still shows up at Ragnarok to plunge his sword into the heart of Asgard.
And where is that exactly?
Only Surtur knows.
That looks an awful lot like the later camp to me.
Shall we take care of them, brother? That's all of them.
Father, are those the same raiders we rescued our wolves from when they were pups?
Yes. These were cold raiders. Wolf eaters.
I bet they have other camps around here. So, I'd like to take care of them so they can't hurt any more animals.
Perhaps.
Thinking about what you both said, after what happened to Brock, that there's some things we just can't control. I know you were trying to comfort me, but how do we tell ourselves our fate is ours to make? And then when the worst happens, you say there's nothing we could have done.
Win minds, not wars.
Tyr understood the greatest fight of them all was the battle for people's hearts and minds. About the oracles of your land, would you say they manipulated events? Did they have an agenda?
I do not doubt they held their own interests first, but in my experience, they could be easily fooled by their own prophecies.
Would that be a specific experience, brother?
Once, I sought the oracle for a means to break my bondage to Ares. One priestess had visions that showed her Olympus would be brought to ruin by the god of war. Therefore, she helped me, intending to undermine Ares and protect her realm. She did not foresee that I would kill him and take his office. But enough of that for now.
The tree in Niflheim just got a new guest.
Brother, can you finish what you were saying about the oracle of your homeland? She helped you against the god of war because she had visions that the god of war would bring down Olympus.
Yes, and in defeating Ares, I became the god of war. In the end, I proved her vision of doom correct.
So the oracle herself brought about the very future she hoped to avoid. I suppose we're in fine company at that.
Okay, all the armies are probably gathered in their home realms. waiting for when we blow Gjallarhorn. Guess I was kind of hoping to see some of them here.
When all the realm towers open at once, we'll see plenty, lad. Odin won't believe what's coming for him.
No. Odin had lifetimes to prepare for this. Whatever Gror's deception, he heard the truth as Tyr. Do not underestimate him.
Rousing speech, brother. Very inspirational.
Wow. The Valkyries look different.
Welcome back. Hilda Sfini informed me of your success. We've been planning accordingly.
Well, what would Ragnarok be without Ragnarok?
Who else agreed to join us? I see the Valkyries.
Better than that. They are reborn. Corporeal and uncorrupted, thanks to no small amount of Vanir magic. They're shield maidens now.
Nice.
And your brother?
He came through. The elves called a truce to unite against Asgard. That gives us an advantage by air, and with Hel's army for a vanguard.
What about Sindri? Will the dwarves fight?
We haven't heard from him. But there's time yet. And I think we have what we need to clear a path for the Ragnarok beast.
Well, when you say it like that, why worry at all? Sigrun! It's good to see you so... alive.
Oh. Yes. I wasn't myself when last we met. I'm glad you're safe. My queen, the Shield Maidens will be divided among the forces breaching from Alfheim, Helheim, and here in Midgard. We stand ready. Kratos, Atreus, Ymir. Please excuse me.
Oh. Good night, then.
Freya, have you determined our path out of Asgard?
If the towers are the way in, we count on them being the way out.
And if they are not?
Then we all know what we signed up for. Our plan is only missing one thing. A leader.
That honor is yours. You have a righteous claim. And the respect of your troops. And you have faced this enemy before.
I held his invading army to a stalemate. This is our invasion. A siege on his terrain. I want our most experienced wartime general in the field. I don't care about the honors, I don't care about the prophecies and champions. I just need us to win.
Freya.
I know what I'm asking. Just... sleep on it? Here we are. Kratos, your tent is to the right. And Atreus, yours is to the left.
Mine?
A young warrior needs his own space, don't you think?
I do. Wow. Thanks.
Sleep on what we spoke of. Let me know in the morning what you decide.
Hildi!
Fire!
Excuse me. May I have a moment with Mimir? I don't know what tomorrow brings, but if tonight is our last night, I'd like to spend it feeling something besides hate. Will you tell me one last silly story?
There's nothing I'd like more, except perhaps a dance. Though I may have lost a step. Due respect, love. I don't tell silly stories.
You only tell silly stories,
Mimir. I can never argue with you.
Can I sleep here tonight?
Quiet your mind.
I can't.
Then I will tell you a story.
If I fall asleep, promise you'll finish it tomorrow?
Of course. Now, close your eyes. There was an old man who chopped wood for his village. Every evening he bore the logs on his back and delivered them to his people. But the logs were heavy, and he grew weaker as time went. And one day, he threw down the logs as he could no longer bear their weight. And he called for death to come to him. And when death arrived,
only one who ever got my highbrow sense of humor. Damn fine woman she was. Apart from her taste in men, of course.
She was a special woman. She wanted to protect people.
She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home.
Has my request upset you? F is a natural part of life, my love. I wish only to be prepared for when my time comes. Mortals must do such things. I am glad to have you prepare with me. You are quiet.
I have nothing to say.
Well, say something. I enjoy hearing your voice.
A funeral pyre. I would have chosen different.
Oh? You would have me trapped in the ground for eternity.
I would have you close to me.
How touching. My rotting corpse would bring you such comfort. You once tried to take charge of your ending, did you know?
That was different.
Circumstance, yes. But not on purpose.
You prepare for a distant future. There is much time ahead of us.
I wish to better a future that will exist without me, whenever that day comes. For you, and for our son. We will always walk together, Kratos. You will always be a part of me. I will always be a part of you.
And when you are gone, that part of me dies as well. You feel your absence?
No. Culmination of love is grief. And yet we love, despite the inevitable. We open our hearts to it. When the pyre is spent, and you have gathered my ashes, spread them from the highest peak in all the realms. You will do this for me. To grieve deeply. is to have loved fully. Open your heart to the world as you have opened it to me, and you will find every reason to keep living in it.
What's going on?
It is time.
I'll meet you outside, Father. Sir.
We'd hope to fly into battle with you one more time, my queen.
Me too. But not as your queen. As sisters. Are you ready?
Yes. I will be your general.
It will be an honor to fight alongside you, General.
Aye, brother. I'll be right by your side. So, what are your orders?
To the temple.
Chillin' with Charlie. With Charlie. We're chillin'. Charlie. Chill with Charlie.